This is Tesla Engineering. We're in the lab and we've been working on some stuff. We just wanted to share it with you. We're trying to make some ventilators out of some car parts so that we can help out the medical industry without taking away from their supply.
With everything happening in the world right now, Tesla's factories are largely shut down and not building cars. But that doesn't mean that they haven't been using their engineering prowess to do something productive. A lot of what Tesla's been doing lately is building ventilators. And that's a great example of how companies can build products that aren't exactly what they've traditionally done. And recently I've been reading some tweets from Elon that he's been thinking about building home air conditioning HVAC systems.
Have you thought about creating an air conditioning system?
Cannot answer questions about future potential products.
And as crazy as that sounds, I don't think it's out of the realm of possibility. And in this video, let's talk about what that might look like and why building an HVAC system for your home isn't the craziest thing Tesla might actually want to consider doing. But as always, before we begin, thank you so much for watching. If you're new, consider hitting that subscribe button, the bell icon. We're a channel dedicated to the future of technology, energy, and transportation. I'm Ricky, and this is 2-Bit Da Vinci. I think a lot of us look at Elon Musk as our personal Iron Man, our Tony Stark, the person with the kind of resources to do great things in the world. And that's kind of what he's done. And I'm not going to lie, I've had some ideas about HVAC systems that I'd want to build if I had billions of dollars in the bank. But until that day comes, let's talk about what Elon and Tesla might be cooking up. First, the reasons why they're doing this, or they might do this. Number one is that the HVAC system in your house represents about 40% at least of your energy consumption. That means you take your refrigerators and your computers and your TVs and all that stuff, and your HVAC, the heating, cooling, and the furnace and blower, that system in your house consumes more energy than any of those appliances. And in the hot summer months, that could be even as high as 60 or 70% of your bill. So clearly, if they can make some optimizations or improvements to make these systems more efficient, the end carbon footprint reduction would be huge. And that's, I think, one of the main reasons why I'd be really interested to see what Tesla would come up with. HVAC systems also don't require any batteries. And the reason why I bring that up is because power walls have suffered as a result of being cell and battery starved because of all their cars. So if Tesla builds more power walls, they can't build as many cars because, again, the battery production just isn't there yet. So what's really cool about this is it's a new kind of a business and it wouldn't come at the cost of anything else. They can keep doing their power walls and their cars. This would be kind of a standalone business that doesn't really impact anything else. Also, Tesla has a good track record of biodefense systems and things in their cars, and really good HEPA filtration and general air filtration systems. So all their lessons learned could potentially translate into something for the house. Here in California, we had wildfires last year that left people with no power, and the air quality was so bad that people were recommending staying inside. But that same air outside makes its way indoors as well. So in the event of some fire or some other emergency situation, having a really good air filtration system could be a huge benefit. So rather than buying individual air filters for each room that you plug in and they, you know, cycle through a couple of hundred CFMs of air, this would be a whole house air filtration system, because the average HVAC system for your house has a central inlet that sucks in all the air for the entire house, and it can be as powerful as 2 to 3,000 CFM, which means that all the air in your house can be purified maybe even once or twice an hour. And as a result, the air quality would be really high in every room. You wouldn't have to go and buy a different air filter for every room. And your HVAC system actually usually has three settings: fan, which is just the blower, and if all you wanted was the air filtration, you leave it on blower, and that doesn't use that much electricity and it'll clean all the air in the house. The other two would be heating and air conditioning, of course. Another reason why they might want to enter this space is because I think there's enough profit margins for them to be excited about it. The average HVAC system can cost between $10,000 to $20,000 installed, and if your house is really big, maybe even more. So as a result, entering this business might potentially make sense, because I think if they could build something at scale, they could, including install costs, they could still sell this for $10,000 or $12,000 or $15,000 and be highly profitable. There's a furnace and blower that sits usually in your garage. There's a compressor for the air conditioning that sits outside of your house. You've seen the Nest thermostat or the Ecobee. There's a control module. There's electrical work to be done with your service panel. And there's also ductwork. So even if you have ducts already run and you have vents in every room and all you're doing is changing the furnace and the compressor, still, Tesla might have some install costs involved. And I'll talk more about that in a little bit. Another aspect that Elon has mentioned in his tweets is that the average air conditioning cycle actually produces clean water out of the air. So the cooling coils cool the air so much that the resulting water in the air condenses out. And most air conditioning systems will pump this out or, you know, throw it out into a drain. But what Elon was saying is, what if we built like a little tap and a 5-gallon water pitcher that we could collect this water from? So now your home would not just be heating and cooling, but also generating maybe a gallon or two of pure fresh drinking water every day. And in these uncertain times, fresh drinking water is another one of those things that suddenly becomes really important. In fact, my good friend Ben Sellens on his channel recently reviewed a solar-powered water generator that takes just solar power and it will take the water out of the air. And that's a really cool product that I think would make sense for backup emergency water. And we'll put a link to that in the description. So now your home isn't just four walls and a ceiling. Now if you have solar panels, you're making your own energy. And with this, you'd be heating and cooling your house, plus even making water. The next reason why Tesla would have an advantage in this market is their integration with solar and their cars. So imagine on a hot day and the sun is shining, you're making electricity with your solar panels and you have extra. Normally you would feed it to the grid for a credit. But if the time of the day or your utility company isn't really giving you that much of a credit at that time, imagine if you could instead say, hey, let's run the air conditioning and keep the house cool at this time because we have the excess solar, because our power walls are charged and everything else is taken care of and we have extra energy to use. That's the sort of integration that can happen when the power wall and the solar and the furnace can all talk to each other. And when it comes to your Tesla car, the integration is equally interesting. Right now, if you pull down on the Navigate To button on your Tesla GPS UI, you'll be navigated to home. And imagine when you do that, if your HVAC system knew, okay, he's 45 minutes away with traffic, it takes 30 minutes to cool the house, I'll start cooling the house in 15 minutes. That way, when he walks in the door, the house is perfectly cool. It would all work seamlessly. You don't have to tell it anything. You just do your thing and the car would know when you're coming home. And it can even get smarter predictively as well. The next thing is room by room control. Right now, the reason why furnaces and HVAC systems are pretty dumb is because they power your entire house, meaning they heat or cool every room, whether or not you're in them. And some companies have come up with some solutions. For example, Keen has a Wi-Fi smart vent that you install in your house, and they're pretty expensive, and you install these in all the different locations, and then your room can either be turned on or off based on if you're actually occupying it. So if you have two guest rooms that no one's in, the vent can just close and no heating and air would be wasted on that. That's cool, but the problem is these are very expensive systems. They're battery powered because there's no hardwired power to them. They have to have radios for Wi-Fi or Bluetooth or whatever the communication protocol is, motion detectors, and all these other smarts and circuits that make these things very expensive. The key really is to not need batteries. Do you really want to be climbing up and changing batteries in your vents every week or so? Because again, there's a motor to move the flaps to open and close them. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to go and get a ladder and change the batteries in my vents. I want something that's hardwired in. And this is where I mentioned when Tesla does the install, what they could do is run a power wire, like a low voltage DC line, along with all the vents to every room. And you could hardwire in Tesla's version of this, where you have a smart vent and you have motors that open and close it, but it's all hardwired in. As a result, there's no batteries, and you can even have communication happening back and forth. So imagine now you have a smart vent that has just one sensor, maybe a motion detector, and those are very cheap. If you have a motion detector, it can tell when someone walks into a room. From there, it could report that back over the wire to a central brain. So now you don't have to have individual SoCs and chips and all this complicated and expensive machinery and circuitry in every single vent. Instead, you can have one brain that has all these inputs from all the different rooms and handle all that kind of in a seamless and integrated way. One of the great optimizations that have happened in HVAC lately is variable speed blowers. Maybe you need full speed ahead because it's a really hot day and every room needs heating or air, or maybe you don't. And so I think what Tesla could do is come up with a really good system that has like a low power, medium, high, very high settings. And If it's one person, you live by yourself, you wake up and you go into the living room in the day, and maybe all that you have to cool is the living room area. And they could even build machine learning to figure out your patterns and predictively heat and cool areas of your house. But if they could do that, you wouldn't have to run a huge compressor all day at 5 kilowatts, for example. Instead, maybe you run 1 or 2 kilowatt compressor, and then you can run the fans and blowers accordingly. But that would be a huge reduction in energy consumption. And people have tackled this piecemeal. But the reason why I personally would never recommend a Keen type smart vent right now is being battery powered, they're super expensive, and I just don't want to deal with that hassle. I think the first company who installs the system and the vents and does all the wiring and does all this as a one complete package will be the winner. And I think Tesla could be the ones to do that. The other thing too is Tesla makes really beautiful products. Their home chargers, the power walls, they're all really attractive and kind of a focal point of your house instead of an eyesore. And the average HVAC system today isn't pretty. The furnace and blower isn't pretty, mine isn't, and the compressor that sits outside isn't pretty. But I'm just imagining what Tesla would come up with. I think theirs would be gorgeous. And here's kind of what I think it could look like. And now, instead of being a part of your house that you kind of tuck away and you never show people, it would be a beautiful accent in your garage and the compressor outside. So that's kind of the reasons why I think they should make it. Now, what you need to do this and to enter this space is you have to have some HVAC engineering knowledge, the refrigeration cycle, HVAC, all those sorts of things. And I think Tesla already has them because they have HVAC systems, really efficient, really advanced HVAC systems in their cars. So I think getting started would be as simple as Tesla taking their HVAC design teams and putting them to work on a home larger HVAC system, tying in their software people and all their hardware and sensor people to build this single integrated solution. This is pretty much how they built their ventilator designs. They had some parts that they've already had in the past, threw them together, and their engineers were able to come up with a design pretty quickly. And I think there's that same kind of synergy with this as well. They have a lot of the expertise and parts and everything else kind of on hand. So now Tesla would be building solar to power your house. They have power walls for power, battery backup, and now even HVAC, the largest appliance in any house. And I think it all kind of makes sense. So what do you guys think? Would you want to see this from Tesla? Do you think it's a good allocation of their resources? They have so many things that they're working on, and they're one of those companies that just inspire us, right? Every time we have an idea and we think, wouldn't it be cool if... I always think, ooh, Tesla should do that, because I feel like they just might. And I got to say, I think this is one of those things. What do you guys think? Am I crazy here? Do you agree? I'd love to have your inputs as well. Let me know what you think. What would be a cool add-on or a killer feature that would push you over the top to want to get this? I'm really curious what you guys come up with. You guys always have really insightful comments. And a special thank you to our patrons on Patreon. You guys know how much we love you. We've had kind of a rough couple of weeks here with views and stuff, and your support on Patreon is incredibly valuable and a huge part of why we can keep this show going. So thank you so much. And if you want to become a rockstar supporter of this show, please consider joining us on Patreon. Well, that pretty much does it for me. So yeah, let us know your comments. We'll talk to you in the comment section. I'm Ricky, this is Tuba Da Vinci, and we'll catch you guys on the next one.